God, let this be a fitting beginning for Jordan and Keiton as they commit themselves before their family and friends to pursue a Christ-centered life together. This day will become a blur in your memory, but it'll become one that you never forget.
I met Jordan probably when I was in, I've been eighth grade, maybe going into my freshman year of high school, and it was at a high school summer league that her dad actually coached at that high school at the time, Manford High School, when we were in their summer league. So that's kind of where I first ran into Jordan.
He came over and we babysat Connor, and we went across the street and shot basketball, or they played basketball on like the outside playground.
So I came over and kind of played it off a little bit, like I wanted to come see Kate and shoot around with Kate a little bit, but was actually coming to see his sister. So.
He just called me one day and said that he was sorry for everything he's ever done and being an idiot since middle school, and ever since then, we've been together.
When the timing was right, 2 years ago, we got a little more serious about it, and then getting married today.
Jordan and Keiton, it's obvious that the marriage covenant is a very serious commitment, but with it comes the greatest blessings this side of heaven.
Keiton, 2 years ago, I never realized what an incredible journey we'd be embarking on together. I prayed for it, but never imagined it would turn into this.
Jordan, our day is finally here. Our journey to forever starts tonight.
I never would have believed that the young boy with a buzz and a goofy smile would grow into such a strong, hardworking, and loving man that would be waiting for me at the altar. I never dreamed I would find someone who challenged me to see the world in a way that you do. A man who makes me laugh and love, a man who, even after all these years, still gives me the butterflies.
I just wanted to know that I love you more than I could ever describe to you in a letter. I know without a doubt that you were meant for me and I was meant for you. I thank God every day for bringing us together. You make me want to be a better man. Strengthen our relationship with Christ and always keep us grounded. You are my rock. These last 2 years together have been the best 2 years of my life. Knowing I get to spend the rest of my life with you makes me the happiest guy in the world. No matter what this next phase has in store for us, you can trust that I will always be by your side. You are my best friend and I love you with all my heart.
I love that the past 2 years, I never faced life's challenges without you. You are the reason I fight so hard to be the best person that I can be. You are my soulmate, my other half, the piece in my heart that I was missing. You are more than I ever prayed about, and now we get to celebrate our love. I promise to love you every day and to make you the happiest man on earth. You are the biggest blessing. I couldn't be more thankful God gave me you. I can't wait to see you waiting on me at the end of the aisle. I also cannot promise not to run. Love, your bride.
You are going to me to be the most beautiful bride. I can't wait to see you coming down the aisle to me. You are going to be the most unbelievable wife and mother to our kids someday. I am so excited to start this life together as husband and wife. I love you so much, Jordan. See you soon.
dust off my soul. Gonna listen to some rock and roll. No cares, come what may, I'm making a beautiful day. Gonna drive my car to the sea, swim out far, 'cause I believe that the waves will wash the gray away. I'm making a beautiful day. Let me hear you say, oh, oh, my, my.
Keiton, do you vow to be the spiritual head in your home as God has ordained, to be responsible provider, to be the initiator of love in your relationship, and by God's enablement, do you vow that Jordan can find in you the protection she needs, and that her character will be, your character will be her boast and pride? Well, if so, please say, I do.
I do.
Jordan, do you promise a life of love and devotion to Keiton, to be a source of inspiration for him? Can he look to you for encouragement, honor, and respect? And will you support him in his dreams and pursuits? Do you vow to let your life and love be the motivation that will lead him to greater dependence upon the Lord? If so, please say, I do.
I do.
Our marriage will represent a faith-driven, God-centered relationship. We will always strive to become better followers of Christ through the way we love and the way we live. In our marriage, the we will always come before the me. Time together will not be taken for granted, and our blessings will be used to bless others.
Beautiful day, and that's gonna be my